Yeah, what is it?
Paula? Hi, it's me, Nancy.
Nancy? Baby, oh. What in the world are you doing in Hollywood? How did you get here?
I just got off the bus.
Oh, why didn't you let me know? I could have met you at the depot.
Well, I didn't know myself until 2 days ago. I finally made up my mind and, well, here I am.
Oh, baby sister. You look wonderful. Oh, how are the folks?
Oh, fine. Fine. Everyone's fine.
Oh, sit down, baby. Let me look at you.
Oh, I want to look around. Oh, you really have a gorgeous place here. Just like I always thought it would be.
Are you on a vacation?
Nope. I'm here to stay.
To stay?
Yeah, well, you were doing so well as a fashion model. I thought I'd try my luck. And I just hope my luck will be as good as yours. You've really got it made. Why, the kids at the drugstore should see you now. They'd all be green with envy. Just like I am. Only I'm going to do something about it.
What do the folks have to say about all this?
Oh, they didn't like the idea at first. But then they decided as long as I'd be with you, I'd be all right. Well, I'm not a child anymore. 22 is no adolescent. As you can see. Well, how do you think I'll do?
Oh, honey. Come here. Sit down. You know what I think? I think you ought to go right back home.
Paula, why?
Oh, this is no kind of place for you, baby. Believe me.
But why not? Why, look at all it's done for you.
Yeah. It's done a lot for me. You talk about envy. You know something? I envy you. Oh, I'd give a lot to be back home right now. Married. Maybe even a couple of kids. I thought you'd be married by now. What was his name?
Johnny Lee? Oh, he's a nice guy. But how much can you take of hanging around the drugstore and the movies every Saturday night? And, oh, those corny gags. Well, once in a while, we really go mad. We go out for a couple of drinks and dancing.
So what's wrong with that?
Oh, I wouldn't mind if I had fun. But how can you? Why, the swankiest place in town has the linoleum floor. They never heard of upholstery. I bet you go to the places. Thick carpeting and full orchestras. Oh, you must have wonderful times. Nightclubs and floor shows. Just about everything.
Nancy, you're going first thing in the morning.
Paula!
Oh, you'll be much happier there, I promise you.
There's nothing at home that can make me happy. Absolutely nothing.
You may think I'm being unkind now, but someday you'll thank me.
Thank you? For what? For sending me back to a tomb? Where people aren't alive, where you always know what tomorrow's like because it never changes from today or yesterday or the day before.
Oh, man, I'm only trying
You're only trying to save all the gravy for yourself. Well, make room, sister. The youngsters are moving in.
Now, wait just a minute, Nancy.
Just a minute? I've waited 22 years.
Exactly. What do you think you'll accomplish by staying here?
I'll tell you what. This. This. Oh, to live, Paula. Can you understand that? Just to live.
Live? You call this living? This isn't living. This is a sham. A lie. A delusion. Nancy.
Hi, Geri.
Oh, what is it now?
I thought you might be having tea for the alumni.
Oh, damn it, Liz, why don't you leave me alone?
Where else can I go, Paula? How many people would understand?
Oh, wait a minute.
Thank you. Yeah. Things this bad. Competition getting rough.
Wow. What planet's she from?
Never mind.
What a creep.
That's enough, Nancy.
Well, I've never seen her horrible.
Shut up!
Well, I only said that she...
I'll tell you what she is. She's you in another few years if you don't get out of here.
Well, all I can say is this is a fine way to treat a sister you haven't seen in 4 years.
You're going home.
I am not.
First thing in the morning, I'm taking you down to the depot and sending you back where you belong. I know I sound mean. I also know you've heard that for your own good routine. But believe me, Nan, it is.
All right, Paula, all right. Get off my back. I don't want to stay where I'm not wanted. It's time to get up.
It's about time.
What?
You should have been here a half hour ago.
I don't think that...
They're in there with a bowl of waxed fruit. How long do you think that will last? Get in there.
Well, I think there's been some mistake. I'm here to see Mr. Barnes.
You're not the 10:30 girl. Oh, I suppose I'll be held responsible. It's always something, one thing or another.
I'd just like to see Mr. Barnes.
Well, he's busy.
Well, I can wait.
Well, wait if you want. It'll be time.
Well, I could come back.
Miss, can't you see I've got troubles? The model doesn't show up, and I've got a half a dozen impatient men in there. And you know what they're doing. Well, I'll tell you what they're doing. They're painting a bowl of waxed fruit. Now I ask, how do you expect us to keep our clientele with situations like this?
Well, if I could see Mr. Barnes...
Oh, Mr. Barnes. He's supposed to be in there, too, instructing. Oh, they're going to be livid. Oh, just livid. And I'll be held responsible. Just you wait and see.
Well, it's about time.
But...
You should have been here half an hour ago.
But I'm not the 10:30 girl.
Well, who are you?
I'm Nancy...
Is that all?
Nancy Walker. You're Mr. Barnes?
Hmm. You're a model?
I just got out to the coast. I'm looking for jobs.
Modeling?
Naturally.
You've had experience.
New York.
Figure modeling?
Sure.
You have some stills?
Let's not waste time, Barnes. We've got things to do. She'll be fine.
All right. This is Mr. Sogel, my boss.
His associate. You can go to work right now.
Fine.
Edwards will take you to the dressing room. Then go right on into the studio. They're waiting.
Well, thank you, Mr. Barnes. Thank you, Mr. Sogel.
All right, come along.
take off your clothes. Follow me. You were fine, just fine. Now, here's a little something for you. And leave your number, and we'll be calling you.
That was easy money.
Well, thank you.
Small change. That's nothing for a girl like you. You know, you got class. I went in and took a look. Different kind of fresh class. You know, a girl with your talent can do all right by herself if she's smart. But not here. You belong with class. I like you. I'm gonna do you a favor. How would you like to go to the colony?
But Mr. Sogel.
Colony?
That is for the very best. That is class.
The colony, it's a private club, Miss Walker. It's really quite an honor to be asked to go, especially for one who, some of the most important, the wealthiest men in this section go there to, for relaxation. It's really very...
And it pays much better.
Sounds good to me.
Fine. Barnes?
Oh, yes. You can leave this afternoon to get there for the weekend. See Mr. Perini. We'll let him know you're coming. Now, I'll give you some directions here on how to get there.
Call the colony. Get Perini on the phone. I want to talk to him. Today!
Oh, yes, sir.
Now, here are the directions. Now, have you got everything else you need? A bathing suit, a negligee?
No, I...
Well, here's some expense money. Get them. And anything else you might need.
Well, thank you, Mr. Barnes.
They'll send someone to meet the bus.
And thank you.
I have Mr. Perini on the phone.
Edwards.
Yes.
I want to speak to you in the studio.
Oh, all right.
Hello, Vito. Bernie. Yeah, I'll be down to see you soon. Listen, the reason I called, I'm sending down another one. Name's Nancy Walker. Quite a girl. Says she's had a lot of experience, but I doubt it. Anyhow, she's a good one. Show her the ropes and treat her right. She's valuable just the way she is.
Don't worry, Bernie. I'll take care of her. You know me.
Yeah, I do know you, Vito. That's why I'm mentioning it. I said I want you to treat her right, and I mean it. No rough stuff, understand? We've had enough of that. She'll be on the 1:30 bus. Meet her and give her no...
Okay, Bernie, okay. 1:30 bus, huh?
Seems that I'm hearing a voice which is urgently requesting my presence.
I've got a job for you.
Which is being to what extent?
I'm getting another one.
We haven't told me yet what is the first one.
I'm talking about a girl. Now, there is. She isn't very experienced, but valuable.
When they're valuable, they're never very experienced.
Yeah, all right. Nevertheless, we got to keep her just the way she is.
Whatever you're saying, boss.
I'm saying take good care of her.
Sure, boss. You know me.
I know you, Joker. That's why I'm mentioning it. Now, don't goof off. This is important. She'll be on the 130 bus.
130 bus.
Meet her.
Meet her.
We'll give her nothing but the best.
The best. Mr. Perini, you know that I'm the epitome of consciousness.
Of unconsciousness.
Unconsciousness.
Take care of it and bring her to me.
120 bus. 130 bus.
Buster.
Am I not incorrect in assuming that you're the doll that's getting off the 130 bus for being picked up?
Get lost.
Listen, mademoiselle, you're supposed to be getting in.
That's not how it went in the book I read.
Well, leave us quit this unpleasant banter. I know the password.
Games, no.
Try this. Perini? The colony?
Well, why didn't you say so?
I did. Greetings.
Who's the new gal?
Not bad, huh?
Yeah, don't sample the merchandise.
Who, me? I'm the epitome of unconsciousness.
One Nancy Walker, delivered in Tackett.
Hello.
Let's see them.
The legs down. Raise your squirt. Yeah, I've seen him already in the car. You should pardon the expression, unmitigated.
Yeah, nice, nice. You'll do fine. Sit down. This is your first trip down here, so I'll break it down. Our guests are treated well. They come back. They pay us, and we pay you. And everybody's happy. As long as our guests are. Understand?
Sure.
Good. You'll find, Nancy, that we are all nice people here. And I'm sure you'll get along just great. She'll bunk with Easy in 211.
After you, Dal.
Hey, Jimmy!
Your indulgence is requested, Easy. Pleased to be informed that you're now a co-tenant of this room.
How do, hon? Glad to have you aboard.
Hi.
This charming damsel is by name Easy. She's not so ferocious as she looks.
I'm Nan. Nancy Walker.
Well, sit down, hon. Take the load off.
Be pleased to clue her in, Easy. She's maybe a bit green.
Don't pay any attention to Joker, hon. We just keep him around for laughs.
It's your first trip around, huh?
Well, come on, hon. It's not that bad.
Well, I don't mind telling you, I'm a little worried.
What's to worry about? Believe me, hon, you've got all the qualifications.
Well, I don't know.
There's nothing to worry about. She'll get along fine. One place is just about like another. Colony's a little swankier, that's all. Face it, you must have had some experience, or you wouldn't be here.
Well, I haven't had as much experience as I led Mr. Barnes to believe.
That's nothing to worry about. You'll catch on fast enough.
I understand all the men are rich.
Rich? They're loaded.
I'm surprised you haven't latched on to one.
I have, for plenty.
No, I mean married one.
Are you kidding? These guys come down here for a ball, not a ball and chain. Marriage.
Well, I don't know.
These guys have had all they want of wives for a while. Why do you think they're here?
There's just one thing to remember, Nan. One thing, and you'll be all right. Cooperate. That's all. Cooperate.
front and center. And you can bring the rest of you along also.
Oh, here we go again.
I'm the bearer of urgent instructions. You book some damsels out to get the bodies into bikinis and report. Toot sweet.
What now?
You heard the man. Got a bathing suit?
Perfect.
Put it on. Put it on.
Nan, meet Mr. Parker.
How do you do?
I haven't seen you around before.
Oh, she's a new one, George. Real nice.
That's an understatement if I ever heard one.
Yeah, well, nothing but the best for you, George.
It's beautiful down here.
Yes, isn't it?
You come here often?
Every chance I get. That is when I can conveniently get away from the office.
I've never been here before, but I know I'm going to love it. Oh, are you going to take some pictures?
Yes, I thought I would. I thought the trees out back would make a nice background.
Oh, fine.
Well, shall we pick a spot?
Sure.
See the tree I was telling you about?
Oh, nice.
Isn't that a perfect spot? Hmm? Ah, just a little bit to the sun. That's it. Now hold it. A little more. Fine. Now, let's try it without the jacket, hmm? Let's lift this off. There we are. Oh, that's lovely. Lovely. Let's take the straps off, hmm? There we are. Lovely. Fine. Oh, that'll make a pretty picture.
Why, it's so peaceful. Nature in the raw.
That's how I like it.
What?
Nature in the raw.
Well, how do you want it this time?
Let's try it like this, hmm? Thank you.
got here.
Well, just the same, I'm leaving. Well, nobody can tell me what to do.
Well, Nietta, just dandy. We'll talk to Mr. Perini about this.
And stay there.
Operator, I want to place a collect call to me. Miss Paula Sheridan in Hollywood.
Do you have the number?
No, no, I don't know the number.
A moment, please. I'm sorry, your party does not answer. Shall I try again in 20 minutes?
No, no, never mind. Get me the police, hurry.
Lieutenant Bushinsky. One moment, miss. Would you give me that address, please? Colony.
Please hurry. I'm trapped. I...
What are you trying to pull? Wise kid, huh? What did I tell you not more than an hour ago? Cooperate.
Please.
Oh, you've got a lot of nerve.
He tried to...
He pays for it, don't he?
But I...
But you didn't know. What do you think you're here for? You don't look that dumb to me. You knew what you were doing when you took our money and bought your pretty clothes. You know who's paying the bills around here, and you know why. Look, you made a bargain, so don't get cute on us. There's nothing you can do but cooperate. That's your job, and don't you forget it. Mr. Parker is a good customer. We like it that way. We can't afford to offend him. He's an influential guy downtown. You can't afford to offend him either. Look, get smart, kid. He likes you. He can do a lot for you. You play your cards right, and you'll get ahead fast. He'll introduce you to the right people. Hey, I could ruin you right now. Ruin you! You want to make a choice? Okay. You got a choice. You can have either this or nothing.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry I offended him.
So now I know it. But what about him?
I'll apologize.
Well, that's better. He's in his room. A little cooperation is all we ask around here, and nobody gets hurt.
How's the water?
Oh, it's fine. You going in?
Yes, ma'am, and I'll need that towel.
Oh!
Back to the pool and tell the rest of them to stay there. Hello, boys.
Hello, Perini.
What brings you guys up to my neck of the woods?
Here you're having some trouble.
Trouble? Here.
Oh, we got a call.
Ah, must be some mistake.
No mistake.
Look, if there were any trouble, don't you think I'd know about it? I tell you, nothing's wrong. The place is yours. Look around.
Knowing you, Perini, that means you've got it all cleaned up before we get here.
Yeah. Well, look, I hate to see you make this trip for nothing. What do you say you come in and have a drink?
You know better than that, Perini. Watch out, Perini. One of these days.
Hey,
I just wanted to tell you how sorry I am.
Oh, that's all right. Would you like a drink?
I just can't believe it. It's so gorgeous. Fix it for me, will you? Oh, he's so sweet.
You're really moving fast, kid.
Well, anything wrong with that?
Nothing at all. They don't come across early in the game. They usually don't come across at all. Crazy kid, you better simmer down.
Oh, easy.
I mean it. You gotta know what you're doing all the time. And go easy on the drinks, too, honey. This party's not for us, you know. Oh, I sure hope they take it easy tonight. Bushed. You know, I think I'm getting too old for this kind of thing.
Oh, come on.
Sure beats working on a chorus.
And easy are on their way down.
Hey, here they are now.
How are you this evening?
Oh, just fine.
Well, old girl, you're looking sharp this evening.
Thanks.
Debbie, why don't you get up and entertain our guests?
Would you really like me to?
John?
Sure, go right ahead. I'll enjoy it.
Well.
You will.
Me anymore?
Sure.
You know something? I like you. I like you a lot.
That's just great.
Why, you're just my type. You know, you old broads got it all over these young chickens. Why, I don't care if you ain't pretty anymore. You're pretty to me. In other ways.
Why don't you go home to your wife?
Hey, what's the matter, Perini? What did I do, huh?
No, not a thing, not a thing. That girl there is had...
Oh, that girl's a real broad, broad.
Yeah, that's right. Come on, I'll get you another girl. Don't you worry. Come on.
Good morning.
What's with you?
Little old me?
All right. What's with little old you?
Now he's talking about a mink coat. Really?
I hope you're right.
Oh, you're just bitter, Evie. He means it. A mink coat. Who would ever have thought it?
I made out all right myself last night. I finally got some sleep.
Good morning, damsels.
A lovely morning, Joker.
Seems maybe you're having somewhat of a ball last night, huh? Franny wants you.
Me?
Who else?
Okay, tell him I'll drop by later.
He wants you now. The boss no longer upset about you. He'll get a gold star. ready?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll join you later, Easy.
Yeah, do that, kid.
Hello, Easy. Sit down. How are you?
Look, if you're upset because I took off last night...
Oh, no, Easy, I'm not upset.
I just got a little shut-eyes, all you. You've got to sleep once in a while, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Well, if it's...
Sit down. I think you could use a little vacation, Easy.
Yeah, come to think of it... A vacation wouldn't do me no harm.
Yeah, well, I've arranged for it.
Yeah?
Yeah. I think you've had too much of this mountain air. You know, high altitudes. I'm sending you back to the city.
A vacation?
The Hotel Parthenon.
Skid Row? No.
You do. You never were a raving beauty. But I remember when you had fire. Joker would take you in and turn you over to Agnes down there. Here's some money to tide you over.
No, I won't. I won't do it. Those slimy winos, those dirty, crawling lechers.
Here.
Please, please don't make me go. I'll do anything you want, I swear. Look, Mr. Perini, anything. I'll even scrub floors around here if you want. Just name it.
Do what you're told. You've had it made a long time, Easy. You can't expect to stay on the gravy train all your life. After all, even winos deserve some kicks.
You lousy murdering bum.
Joker! Joker! Hey, dirty. Get her out of here. Take her out the back way. Fast.
What's this?
Boss, Perini, says I should get her out, that I should take her downtown.
All right, put her in the car. And wait here.
Come in.
Hello, Vito. How are things?
Bernie, I didn't expect to see you.
Behaving yourself?
Sure, sure. Things are fine. I had to get rid of one of the girls, though.
Who?
Easy.
How did you get rid of her, Vito?
Oh, it's nothing much. I had to straighten her out, that's all.
How did you straighten her out, Vito?
With your fist?
Now, Bernie, I didn't touch her.
Didn't touch her? From the way she looked out there, you almost killed her. Now, you've been told, Perini, too many times. The last one you beat up that bad one ran into the cops. Now, we can't have any of that, can we?
Look,
you know we can't have any more of that, can we?
It won't happen again, I swear.
I've heard that before. Times has changed, Perini. A few years ago, we used muscle. But not now. You were a good man. We take care of our boys. We even sent you down here to keep you out of trouble. Set you up with a nice, easy take. And all you have to do is be nice to people. Forget your fists!
Look, she tried to kill me.
Perini, when we get through with you, you're gonna wish she had.
Look, Mr. Sobel, one more chance.
I'll take it up with the board of directors. Meanwhile, you take easy downtown to the hotel. And when you get there, tell Agnes that you're the new manager. Stay there until you hear from us, now get out. You heard me, get out! Barnes? Sogel. Listen, I need a girl in a hurry. Who have you got? Yeah? Yeah. Well, what about her? Never mind the biography. She'll do fine. Just have her on her way in an hour.
I was never gladder to see anybody in my life.
And that's the whole story?
Every bit, from beginning to end.
Well, we've known for quite some time what's been going on, but we can never get them into court. Every time we get a possible witness, they refuse to testify. Nobody could say anything without implicating themselves.
I'll do everything I can to help, believe me.
Those bums deserve everything you can give them.
You've helped yourself quite a bit telling us all this. Now, you understand you're just being held as a material witness for your own protection. I hope you won't mind being a guest of the city for a few days.
Mine? I could sure use a vacation.
Now, you'd better go along with the officer. We'll try to make you as comfortable as possible. If you need anything, just feel free to ask.
Thanks.
This is Bushinsky. Notify all units. Set up a rendezvous at 7th and Beaker Streets at 8:30 p.m. Acknowledge.
Come in.
Well, Mr. Sogel, we got here as fast as we could. You remember Paula.
Paula, how are you?
Dandy.
There's a vacancy in room 211.
Okay.
Well, Mr. Sogel, how's everything in this haven of rest?
It could be better. Sit down.
Thank you.
I'm glad you came down. Do you like it here?
It's got class, all right.
You're staying.
I'm staying? What about Perini?
I sent Perini downtown to the hotel. You can take over as manager here.
Well, thanks, Mr. Sogel. I'll do a good job, I promise you.
You know what happens to those who don't. Now, you'd better get out of here and look things over for tonight.
Thanks, Mr. Sogel.
Come in. Well, come in. Very nice. Tell me, how are you getting along down here?
Oh, fine.
Mm-hmm. Just as I said, nothing but the best. Yes, a lot of work and money has gone into this place so that you girls can enjoy yourselves down here.
I was just looking for Easy. She said she was coming down here, and I thought that
Now, don't you worry about Easy. She's a big girl now.
Oh, I'm not worried. We were double dating, that's all.
Well, Easy will be away for a few days.
Oh, well, thank you. This place. How did you get here?
Paula, don't start in on me. Mr. Barnes sent me down. I got his address in your apartment. Paula, I'm over 21. Don't try to run my life.
Nancy, I don't know how to appeal to you. I don't know how to get through to you. Nancy, I don't want to run your life. But do you know what you're doing? This is no kind of life for you, Nancy. Believe me, I know. I know because it's my life. I know what it means.
Paula, try to understand. I like it.
Like it? You don't know it. Oh, I don't know what you've done. I don't know how far you've gone. But, Nancy, you've got to get out of here.
Are you kidding?
If you don't leave now, you'll never get the chance.
Oh, Paula, come off your soapbox. Well, I'm having the time of my life. Look, this is bad. Well, I've never had it so good. And there'll be more, lots more. Leave this?
How did you get it?
I met a man. He's interested in me. He's going to do great things for me. You wait and see. Why, he's even talking about a fur coat. A mink.
Why?
Because he likes me, that's why.
Likes you?
Leave me alone, Paula.
Do you know what you are? There's a very dirty word for what you are. and a very dirty group of people running a very dirty business. Oh, yes, didn't you know? We're highly organized. We've got everything but a union card. And those men, they come down here for one reason, to get girls like you and me to cooperate. And tomorrow they're gone. They go back to their wives. And you say this is the life. This is the way to get expensive things, to live glamorously. Well, you just don't know. You liked my apartment, didn't you? My fur coat, furniture, everything. Well, I like them too. I wish they were mine. They don't belong to me. They belong to the Sogels and the Perinis. So do I. They let me use those things as long as I'm a good girl. As long as I do what I'm told, when I'm told, and with whomever I'm told. And as long as they get their cut. Oh, didn't you know? Haven't they told you yet? You don't think they'd set up places like this, apartments like mine, without expecting a good return on their investment. And what does it leave for me? Furs? Diamonds? Nothing. No laughter. No living. No love. Nothing. And get out? Oh, how I wish I could. But I belong to them. A piece of property they own. Till I break down.
If you dolls would be so good as to excuse me, the management is respectfully requesting your presence in the club room in 10 minutes.
Smith, I'd like you to meet Paula. She'll be your companion for this evening. Have a good time.
Hi there, Paula.
Hi.
Sit down. How about a drink?
Sure.
Hey, we're almost out of liquor. Hey, Joker.
You were summoning me?
Fill her up.
With pleasure.
Come on, Paula. Let's dance. Come on.
Oh, leave me alone.
Well, we'll show them how it's done.
Oh, all right.
We'll show them how to dance around here.
Knock it off.
Let's live it up a little.
Get away from me.
Show
them
how it's done.
Get away from me. All of you. I'm sick to death of your lousy filth. Every one of you. Dirty. Girls who have nothing to sell with their bodies. Who've lost every bit of self-respect and decency they've ever had. One of the lowest forms of life. And you know it. Make you feel good to have it spelled out for you. Make you feel fine inside. Well, it makes me crawl. Because I'm no better than any of you. And our honored guests, our buyers, the fools these sex stores are set up for. You cause it, so you're worse than we are. You don't think for a minute you're treated nicely here because you're admired or even liked. You can't believe these girls just can't resist you because of your charms. Well, look at yourselves. You're all drunks and lechers. It's your money we're after. Lots of it. And we'll sell you all the sex and liquor and degradation you want to buy. All you can afford. Except nobody can afford this kind of thing. It takes much more from you than just your money. All of you with wives who have more goodness in their little fingers than you can find in 40 acres around here. You don't deserve them. You don't deserve anything decent. You're scum.
buyers of sin, traitors in corruption. And here's the man who runs the store, Mr. Flesh Merchant himself. Well, how's business? What's sex selling for these days? And passion and obscenity!
That's enough.
Don't touch me! Get your dirty hands off of me, you swine!
Stop it! Stop it! Leave her alone!
Leave her alone! Go on, daughter! Go on, right!
Time you'll ever shoot off your mouth. Rick, get the car.
All right, folks, stay where you are. You're under arrest.
All right, boys, go clean it out.
Mr. Sogel, I've waited a long time to say this. Won't you join us?